Hi, I'm Shaun Murphy, Senior Engineer and Synchrophaser Project Manager here at PJM, and I'm here today to talk about synchrophasers, how they work, and how PJM uses them to track real-time conditions. Synchrophasers, also known as phasor measurement units, or PMUs, are a high-speed measurement technology that provide data at a rate of 30 times per second. They show a clear, big picture of the electric grid. Think of these devices as providing a panoramic view versus a microscopic view, but in strikingly clear detail. They allow us to measure things that we've never measured before. To understand how these devices work, we need to start with a short math and theory lesson. Large power systems operate on AC, or alternating current power. But what does that mean exactly? It means that voltages and currents seen across the electric grid are represented by three mathematical quantities: the magnitude, frequency, and phase angle. To understand these three things, picture ocean waves. The magnitude can be thought of as the height of a wave. The frequency can be thought of as the number of waves passing a point in 1 second. The phase angle is the relative distance between two waves, or the distance between one wave and a chosen reference point, like a buoy or the shoreline. As generation and transmission lines change to meet real-time demand, these three quantities will change. That is what synchrophasers are measuring. In the context of large power systems, these quantities tell PJM and transmission owners important information. A sudden drop or rise in frequency can alert operators of the loss of a large generator, load center, or transmission line. Locations with the largest change will indicate the source or epicenter of the disturbance, while continuous fluctuations in frequency values can indicate a large power system oscillation event. Magnitude values monitor important quantities like high or low voltage conditions. Phase angles measure the amount of power flowing between two points on the grid. Imagine the grid on a hot summer day. As power consumption rises, power is transferred across the system. As power transfer increases, phase angles will spread apart, signaling more stress on the grid. The same idea applies to how the system is configured. Whenever equipment, like a transmission line or transformer, are removed from the system, angles will spread apart. This is another indicator of stress. Now let's take a look at a synchrophasor device here at PJM. Here we have two standard substation relays that receive signals from voltage and current transformers in the substation. We also have a high accuracy GPS clock that provides a time reference for measuring phase angle and to provide a timestamp on the measurement data. This measurement data from these PMUs are then sent to a central device called a phasor data concentrator, or a PDC. The PDC then sends its information to a local utility company, who sends the information to PJM. PJM uses this high resolution data collected from different points on the electric grid to closely monitor the grid on a 24/7 basis. Having synchrophasors installed across the system allows the operators to view it as one big picture. This data is also used to detect certain high-impact, low-frequency events on the grid, like oscillations, when equipment isn't outputting electricity at a steady rate, and system islands, when a portion of the electric system is separated from the rest. The information allows us to monitor grid stress as well, using heat maps that show hot spots of high electricity use areas. In addition to the real-time applications, PJM uses synchrophasor data for model validation, which is a post-event analysis that allows us to assess whether the system performed the way that we expected. This is done for generation, load, and system dynamic models. PJM is also watching for the next generation of measurement technology like point-on-wave, which is an even faster tool that tracks grid conditions instantly. You can learn more about the advanced technologies that PJM is exploring and supporting by visiting pjm.com and the PJM Learning Center. Thanks for watching.